some men to marry more than one woman to protect the modesty of the woman, not to degrade her. The second question that can come as a counter question by the non-Muslim is that if Islam has allowed a man to marry more than one woman, why aren't the women allowed to marry more than one man? It's a counter question. Why isn't polyandry allowed in Islam? And Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 24, that do not marry the woman who are already married. That means you cannot marry a woman who's already married. That means a woman cannot have more than one husband at a time. Because if you analyze that if a man has more than one wife, and if any children are born out of this wedlock, you can easily identify who the father is and who the mother is. It's very easy. But if a woman has more than one husband, you can easily identify the mother, but you will not be able to identify the father. And if suppose the mother goes to school to admit the child, and if the teacher asks that what is the name of the father, she may have to give two names. You know what such people are called in our society. And today psychologists tell us that if a child cannot identify the parents, the mother and father, he has mental trauma during childhood. That's the reason the children of prostitutes, you know, they have a very bad childhood, mental trauma. So Islam lays a great deal of importance on the identification of the parents. I am aware, being a medical doctor, that today science is advanced, and by doing DNA testing and genetic testing, it's possible, many a times, to identify who is the father and the mother. But Islam is a religion for all times. This test just came recently. This test wasn't there before. And it is expensive. It's not possible for everyone to do it. It may become cheap tomorrow. But this reason that you cannot identify the parents is at least applicable till today. But this is not the only reason why Islam has not allowed a woman to have more than one husband. This is one of the reasons which was applicable till today, may not be applicable in the future. There are various other reasons. For example, by nature, man is more polygamous as compared to the woman. Third reason is that it is much more easier for a man to perform his duty biologically and physically of being the husband of multiple wives than a woman to perform her duties biologically and physically of multiple husbands. Let me explain to you that in Islam, a man and woman, they're equal. But equality does not mean identicality. They're equal, but they aren't identical. Physically, biologically, they're different. Overall, they're equal. But in certain aspects, depending upon the biological nature, depending on the physical nature, there are certain rules which are different for men, certain rules different for women, but overall they're equal. And you can refer to my cassette, Woman That's in Islam, for more detail. Now, a woman undergoes menstrual period. There are certain hormonal changes. There are changes in her behavior, in her mental behavior. That's the reason, if you know the procedure of divorce, Islam says that during a menstrual cycle, you cannot divorce, you know. There are various reasons, etc. So before the menstrual cycle and during that, the hormonal changes, the disturbances, it's difficult for a woman, you know, to maintain a balance. Even as being a wife of one husband, it's possible. But if she has to be a wife of multiple husbands, it will be very difficult. You know, there are mental changes, biological changes, which is not the case in the man. Therefore, biologically and physically, it's possible for a man to be a husband of more than one wife than for a woman to be a wife of more than one husband. And there are other reasons also. Today, medical science tells us that if a woman has more than one sexual partner, means if a woman has more than one husband, and if all of these people are faithful to each other, that means they don't have any extramarital sex, yet if a woman has multiple sexual partners, there can be certain diseases, sexual transmitted diseases, diseases of the cervix, which can originate. If a woman has multiple life partners, even if they're faithful to each other. This is not the case in man. And once the disease originates, it can be retransmitted to the husband. Whereas, in the case of a man, if he has multiple sexual partners, two or three, and if all of them are faithful to each other, if they don't have an extramarital sex, these diseases don't originate. So these are a few of the reasons which I feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his divine wisdom has prohibited a woman to have more than one husband.